We'll be starting the first lesson on Al-Arba'een Al-Nawawi, the 40 hadiths by Al-Nawawi, rahimahullah. So the first hadith is عن أمير المؤمنين أبي حفص عمر بن خطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته لدنيا يصيبها أو امرأة ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه رواه إمام المحدثين أبو عبد الله محمد بن إسماعيل بن إبراهيم بن المغيرة بن بردسبه البخاري وأبو الحسين مسلم الحجاج مسلم القشيري النيسابوري في صحيحهما اللذين هما أصح الكتب المصنفة. So this hadith is narrated by Amir al-Mu'mineen Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu, the leader of the believers, one of the four khalifas, the second khalifa. He says he heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, "Innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat." All actions are by intentions, or actions are by intentions. وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى, and a person will be rewarded with what he has intended. Meaning only what the person intends is what he will get. So whoever's hijrah or migration, so the Prophet ﷺ gives us an example, and he says, whoever migrates to Allah and his Prophet, meaning for Allah's sake and for the Prophet ﷺ's sake, then his hijrah will be for Allah and for the Prophet ﷺ's sake. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ, and whoever's hijrah migration is for to gain some worldly material, or to gain some worldly thing, or to marry a woman, then his hijrah will be for that sake. So this is a hadith, a very important hadith, which shows us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at the hearts when he's judging people. He doesn't look at their physical appearance. So the intentions are very important, and it differentiates between the normal actions that we do and ibadah, and also our intentions should be sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us an example, and he gave an example exact when the Sahaba radiallahu anhum were migrating to Medina from Mecca. So people migrated for different reasons, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saw the intentions. So there were people who migrated because they wanted to do business, this was a hidden intention, or they wanted to get married. Okay, this is a hidden intention. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew. So whoever migrated for anything other than, you know, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake, and migrated to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them, not according to what is zahir or what is apparent, but what is in their hearts. Okay, so this is a very important hadith which is used to differentiate even between murder and manslaughter. If a person commits murder, then the intention is of the person kills someone, the intention is looked at, and there's ruling, there's ahkam that are decided based on this hadith. Also, it shows us that the intention is very important. So when the person is making wudu, he has to have an intention for making wudu. When he's praying salah, he should be making that intention to pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake, and keeping the intention pure and free from shirk, from associating partners with Allah, or by showing off and committing minor shirk. So when a person is doing these very valuable a'mal like hijrah, and then he's doing it for something which is so petty, then the reward is lost. So that's why here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not repeat وَمَنْ كَانَتْ هِجْرَتُهُ لِلدُّنْيَا يُصِيبُهَا وَامْرَأَةٌ يُنْكِحُهَا فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى مَا هَجْرَهِ. So here the ulama say that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't even repeat that intention, because it was so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was belittling a person who does this hijrah, this great amal, for this for this petty intention.